Hey guys, Keaton here with TechSmartt, and this is the evolution of the Nexus. Since January of 2010, we've seen a total of 6 phones. These phones are the Nexus One, the Nexus S, the Galaxy Nexus, the Nexus 4, the Nexus 5, and now we have the Nexus 6. So what is the Nexus? Every year Google teams up with a manufacturer to make a device that will showcase the current version of Android. That device is dubbed the Nexus, and in the past years we've had 6 of them. But how much have these devices actually changed? Let's go ahead and start off with some hardware, taking a look at the Nexus One. The HTC-made device sports a 3.7-inch display, two-toned coloring, and a trackball. The Nexus One styling can still hold its own next to the high-end smartphones of today. Then again, HTC has never had too much trouble making a good-looking phone. Towards the end of 2012, Google and Samsung partnered up to create the Nexus S, and the name comes from the Galaxy S family line of phones. The device had a much more subtle design compared to the Nexus One, with a larger 4-inch display. Gone is the trackball, but this was the first Nexus to showcase a front-facing camera. The Nexus S also had an interesting design trait. It was curved. The display itself wasn't curved, however the glass above the display was curved slightly. The goal here was to make a phone that fits well on the hand and forms your face when you're making a call. Next in line is the Galaxy Nexus, another Samsung-made Nexus device. The Galaxy Nexus brought one of the most notable physical changes to the Nexus line, software buttons, as opposed to the capacitive buttons on previous devices. The Galaxy Nexus also jumped in size to a 4.65-inch display. From a hardware perspective, the Galaxy Nexus was the first next-gen Nexus device, offering all the features we've come to expect from any smartphone today. 4G LTE, a multi-core processor, a large display, and a high-end megapixel with HD video recording. The Galaxy Nexus also retained the similar contoured glass that was showcased on the Nexus S. In October of 2012, Google chose LG to make the Nexus 4. With glass on the front and on the back of this phone, it just felt as fragile as it really was. The device itself had a very different look and feel compared to the previous Nexus devices, including a flat design, eliminating the curved glass. However, with the 4.7-inch display, the overall size of the phone did not change much. Google signed LG to make the Nexus 5, and they built a more practical device. Ditching the glass design, LG used a polycarbonate shell to construct the Nexus. Like the Nexus S, it retained a very minimal, understated design. The screen continued to grow with the generation to a 4.95-inch display and even more powerful specifications. Now we have the Nexus 6, a Motorola-made Nexus device, and it's absolutely huge. Instead of the incremental screen size increases, Motorola jumped all the way up to a 5.96-inch display. Next to the Nexus 1, that is almost double the size. The Nexus 6 inherits most of its design from the 2014 Moto X, however, this is much larger. So taking a look at my Nexus 6, I have a D-brand carbon fiber skin applied, as it just looks absolutely badass. I love the cutouts on here, and it just adds a lot more grippiness to the device. So a fun fact here, when I pulled the Nexus 6 out of the box, it just slipped out of my hands, and that really just depends on how you hold it, but once I applied the skin to it, I was pretty much all set to go. So if you want to check out this skin in particular or other options they have on their website, I'll leave a link right below that like button on this video. It is clear that every manufacturer adds their own design touch to the Nexus. Many of the changes from the Nexus 1 to the Nexus 6 are simply to help accommodate the larger display. The power button has been repositioned to the right-hand side, and the software keys replace the capacitive keys, allowing for less bezel. But what hasn't changed over the last 4 years? In terms of hardware, not much. Obviously, there's still a camera, there's still speakers, and of course, there's still a display, but that's really it. Hardware on the Nexus devices is ever evolving, but that's kind of the point. Each device carries characteristics specific to the time that they were created. Google didn't create the Nexus line to tout hardware, but they used it to show off their vanilla, unadulterated stock Android experience. While there were versions of Android before it, Android 2.1 Eclair was one of the first versions of Android on the Nexus One. Our Nexus One is running Android 2.3 Gingerbread, adding support for NFC, front-facing cameras, as well as an overall speedier performance. Android 2.3 at its core is still very similar to the Android today. However, the dated UI, lack of applications, and clunky performance did not make it that favorable. Following Android 2.3, we have Android 4.0 Ice Cream Sandwich on the Nexus S, although the device originally shipped with Gingerbread. The jump from Android 2.x to Android 4.x can be viewed as the largest step for Android to date. The user interface was totally redesigned with software button support, folders, the Roboto typeface, a recent application switcher, and the list goes on and on. Android Ice Cream Sandwich was the first version of Android to carry all the great features from Android 2.x and more, and look good doing it. The Galaxy Nexus was the Android 4.0 poster child with a large screen and software buttons, and this one really just showed the capabilities of Android 4.0. Our Galaxy Nexus is running Android 4.2 Jelly Bean. The design changed slightly from Android 4.0 to Android 4.1 through Android 4.3, but performance was the goal. Codenamed Project Butter, Android 4.1 brought all the goods of Android 4 in a much snappier package. Jelly Bean also introduced resizable widgets, actionable notifications, and the support for 4K resolution phones. The Nexus 4 shipped with Android 4.2 Jelly Bean, although our unit is on Android 4.4 KitKat, which originally shipped on the Nexus 5. Android KitKat was the final build in the remarkable Android 4 evolution, and Google redesigned KitKat for a more modern feel. They also introduced immersive mode, which allowed apps to run full screen without the notification bar. Most importantly, Android 4.4 was designed to give the full-featured experience on low-end phones by reducing the size of the operating system and requiring less RAM to power the platform. Now we have Android 5.0 Lollipop. This version is native on the Nexus 6 and is drop-dead gorgeous. Google has added guest mode for multi-user support, battery saver mode, and allowed for notifications on the lock screen. But more importantly than all that is material design. That's the latest name for the design on Android Lollipop. Instead of retheming the elements in Android KitKat, material design not only changes the look, but it adds better, more intuitive animations. It redesigned app switcher and refreshes the way you use Android. Over the past 4 years, we've seen Android grow to the advanced platform that we see today, and thankfully each Nexus device has the same unadulterated vanilla Android stock experience the way that Android was meant to be used. The fundamental differences between the Nexus One and Nexus 6 really aren't that major. If you've used an Android device before, despite the design changes, just by picking it up, you can expect to know how to work this phone. And obviously there's new additions along the way, such as NFC and 4K support, just really to keep up with the times. Also, the Easter egg has evolved too. From each operating system to operating system, the Easter egg has just kind of gotten cooler. And with this one, it's kind of a game in Android 5.0 Lollipop, kind of taking its spin on Flappy Bird, which is pretty difficult to master. Nexus devices have been universally knocked for the poor cameras, so let's compare them all and see how they've improved. The specs of each camera are displayed on screen, but rather telling you the specs, let's go and take some photos and see if there's a difference. We've come a long way since 2010, and so have the cameras on these devices. Both with hardware and software being improved, the camera quality has greatly improved. So when planning this video, it was hard to find a way to compare all these specs, as when each device was released, at the time, they had cutting-edge specifications. So instead of running benchmarks on these, let's go ahead and give you guys some real-world performance, open up a few different applications on each device, and see which one is quicker. While this isn't the most accurate way to determine performance, due to the age of these devices, this seems to be the most fair test out of all of them. And that's the evolution of the Nexus. So at the end of the day, all six devices share the same core functionalities, the same branding, and the same respect that we know and love from a Nexus device featuring the stock Android experience. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I know it was a little bit different than my standard types of videos, but if you guys want more and just enjoyed the evolution of the Nexus, then go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up, as it really helps the channel out a bunch. And let me know in the comment section down below, which is your favorite Nexus device to date? Is it the Nexus 6, the Nexus 1? Do you really love a throwback? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Finally, go and subscribe to the channel to be notified when a brand new evolution video comes out, because I really enjoyed my time with all of these devices. It's pretty cool to see how they've changed. So just subscribe, you click it, you're all set to go, and you'll be notified when a brand new video does come out. So thank you guys once again, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.